Capitalism abandoned the traditional hierarchic structure of the production process and developed a network-based form of organization founded on employee initiative, autonomy in the workplace, and so on. It's all this vision of collaborative, participative, postmodern capitalism, creative capitalism, and so on and so forth. And of course, this is the big lesson of 68. How, in what a model way, contemporary capitalism incorporated all the motives of the protesters of 68 for more equality, against hierarchy, against consumerism, and made them tools for even more effective functioning of capitalism. But there is a price we have to pay for this shift. It is commodification of even our intimate erotic relations. What do I mean by this? Did you notice how today, at least in the developed West, by at least everywhere, more and more we are returning slowly, but the tendency is clear, to pre-modern tradition of arranged marriages. It is just that instead of uncles, older relatives, the one who does it are dating and marriage agencies. You present yourself there as a commodity, you describe your properties, and they find an ideal partner for you. This makes me pretty sad. Why? Because what disappears is love here. In what sense? I don't know what expression you have in your language, but in Slovene, it also doesn't work, but it works in French and in English. You know, the expression is to fall in love. Or tomber in French, tomber l'amour. I found in United States publicity for some marriage agency which tells the truth wonderfully. They say, we will enable you to be in love without the fall. You know, like, let's play it safe. Or I was shocked when I flew recently from United States to Europe, and I found that journal Hemispheres of United Airlines, where they also say something like, we are now outsourcing work to third world countries and so on. My addition was, United States even learned to outsource torture to Arab countries, their allies. And they say, isn't it time to outsource falling in love? No, like, if you are an successful businessman or woman, you don't have time for all the procedures of dating and so on. You write down your characteristics, you offer yourself as a commodity, and they found the partner. You will be in love without the fall. But for me, the fall is what love is about. It's precisely this shocking moment of, you know, this magic of love where it's quite contingent, like you enter a cafeteria totally by chance. You meet there someone, and all of a sudden you have this mystical experience, I was waiting for you all my love. Oh, sorry, all my life. This disappears. And I claim sex as such disappears here. So be careful. Today, I claim, people less and less really want sex. They want pleasures. Pleasures, preferably this idiotic, masturbatory, not sexual relationship pleasures. Let me give you a stupid proof indication of this tendency. Did you notice something strange in the last James Bond film, Quantum of Solace? At the end, the first James Bond film with no sex between James Bond and the Bond girl. I mean, then, the worst novel maybe of all times, Dan Brown, The Lost Symbol. Did you notice absolutely no sex? Da Vinci Code, absolutely no sex. I think that in Da Vinci Code, God himself has to make love, Jesus Christ, no? With Mary Magdalene. Why? To cover up the fact that there is no sex here between Sophie and that symbologist, Robert Langdon or whatever. Even stranger thing, the last Dan Brown film, Angels and Demons. There is sex in the novel, but no sex in the film. It is, where are we going? In good old times, we thought Hollywood asks sex, sorry, adds sex to the story to make it more commercial. Now Hollywood is censoring sex to make it more commercial. So this is the structure today. What is the structure? A British psychoanalyst told me a wonderful story of how in he had a patient who told me that the patient made a mistake. He dated a girl and invited her to a restaurant, which was also a hotel up. Of course, the idea was after dinner to take her to a room up. Okay, when he entered the restaurant, he made a mistake, Freudian slip. Instead of saying table for two, please, he said a bed for two, please. Now, my friend Darian Lieder is his name, made a wonderful reading of this joke, of this slip, sorry. He said, no, it's wrong to interpret it just that food was just a pretext, his mind was already with making love. He said, it's the opposite. The guy was afraid that food will be more attractive to him than making love later. So he had to remind himself, let's not enjoy too much food. Remember that the true thing comes afterwards, and so on and so on.